Dear learners, in this video, we will discuss about the production and distribution of multimedia project. So let us begin with the objectives. After completing this video, you will be able to know about the multimedia production and how to distribute the multimedia package to the end user. So let us start with the multimedia production. So the process of creating the related media elements in a multimedia project includes graphics, sound, animation, and digital video. It's called production. So the production means that creating the related media elements and combining and incorporating all the media and to produce the final product. And in multimedia, all this creation of media elements can even be independently we can develop by using various tools, and after producing the individual elements, that means components, then the all the component combined into the one product. For example, the graphic elements are created independently using various computer graphics packages such as 3D Studio or otherwise Paintbrush, etc. After creating this element, then that can be incorporated in the authoring tool. And let us see the steps in multimedia production. So multimedia production, we follow certain steps to from the starting from the planning to the end final product. So adequate time and effort, efficient planning is required for multimedia production, which ensured that the project will be produced smoothly and certainly ensure that the information reaches the target audience. The target audience are the end user who are going to get the benefit from the product. So first step is the conceptual analysis and the planning. The process of multimedia making begin with the conceptual initiation point. That means you have to create the concept. From there you have to get into the planning and designing and then production. So the concept analysis identify a appropriate theme, budget, content availability on that selected theme. So first of all you have to find the theme. For that particular theme, budget is very important, because budgeting is involving more in the multimedia product. And then content analysis, that means content availability. The content availability for that particular theme, that is also we have to analyze. And additionally, the copyright issues, which we have already discussed also. So whenever you are taking the content, you have to take from the copyright issues from the concerned the authors or otherwise the whoever created the creators. For example, in the phase, that means the conceptual space and phase and planning itself, we have to keep the copyright issue. Copyright issues not only for the text based material, it involves all the sound or music or the audio component and also video component. Suppose if you are taking from the YouTube the videos, or otherwise if you are taking the music from the any film musics to insert in your content, then you have to take care of the copyright issue. You have to get the permission from the creator or the author, then only you can utilize in your multimedia product. For example, if you are going to use certain openly available sources, that also you have to take care of some of the licensing, etc. So in the conceptual phase, you have to keep all the information, related information, then only you have to proceed for the next step. Next step is the project design. So once the theme is finalized, the objective, goal and the activities are drawn for the multimedia project. the general statement, that means the broader statement of that particular theme, is called as a goal. That means we have to set the goal for that particular product, and then our specific statement in the project is known as objectives. That means, for example, if you want to create any multimedia product for any website, then that particular specific objective to incorporate the basic information about, that means the vision and mission about the particular website. So that will be the one objective. Like that, you can design many objectives to execute the project. Activities are the series of actions performed to implement an objective. For one objective, to implement or execute one objective, there may be many activities need to be incorporated. For example, introduction of any subject. Introduction of any subject, that is a one objective, if you are saying that, then that part includes various activity. For example, the introduction may be by video and may be by the text-based material, and for that particular video you need an expert, and the content for that video and the plan for that video. So these are the series of activity to execute one objective. Similarly, you have to plan for many activities to execute the entire goal of that particular product. These activities contribute to the project design phase. The third one is a pre-production. So in the pre-production, based on the planning and design, it is necessary to develop the project. Based on the planning and design, there are many steps involved in the pre-production activity. The very important step is a budgeting. So why we are focusing on the budgeting? Because you need to buy a certain hardware, software, and also you need to travel. If you want to get the expert from outside boundary, then you have to travel, or otherwise if you want to shoot the outdoor shooting, that also you need to travel. So traveling expensive, and communication and publishing and also some consultants, that means the expert you need to produce the multimedia project. So for that the budget is involving. So you have to prepare very clear budgeting for your multimedia project. And next step is multimedia production team, which is very important, where that all the consultants or experts are involved in that multimedia product team. So we will explain how the multimedia production team is there. So production team for the high end multimedia project required a team effort, because the one person cannot produce a multimedia package or product. It is a team effort. The team members comprising of they have a very various role and responsibilities, like a scriptwriter, production manager, editor, graphic artist, multimedia artist, and web managers. We will see one by one what are the role for that each and every expert for that particular multimedia production team. And then we need a hardware and software selection, because if you can come across the product or otherwise hardware or software, that there are lot of tools, authoring tools and hardware parts are available, but we have to select the suitable hardware and software for producing the multimedia project. So all multimedia application require appropriate tools to develop and playback. Playback means the user end side. So playback of applications. The hardware includes the selection of faster CPU, RAM, and a huge monitor or sufficient disk space for storing the records. The selection of suitable software and file format depends on the funds available for our project developed, because there are very heavy budget cost softwares are available. For that you have to be select the appropriate, based on your budgeting you can select the software tools also. Coming to the defining the content is a material or stuff to provided by the content specialist to the multimedia architect, which is the application which going to be application is developed, and also that you have to prepare the multimedia architect will prepare the navigation buttons, charts and tables etc. based on the content provided by the content specialist. Why we are having the content specialist? This content specialist role is to take care of all the copyright issues, plagiarism issues and the writing of the content with the based on the final output. And based on the level of the audience, the content specialist provide the material or content to the multimedia architect. That content and specialist will be selecting which part of the content will go by the text based or an audio based or video based etc. Then next one is the preparing the structure. So once this all the, as we already discussed, the each component independently we can develop the each component. So if we developed the various component, then that component will be put together based on the structure which we have created. So detailed structure must be have information about all the steps along with the timeline and the future action. And this structure define the activities, responsibility of the person for each activity and the start and end time of the each activity. So that is the very important. For example, the multiple, we have the multimedia team have different various members involving to develop the product. So each one have the different responsibility. So that based on the activity we have to say that which activity will start first and which activity will be start the second level, so that the product may be very smooth flow will be there to produce the product. And next one is a production. So in the production is that after the pre-production activity, the production phase starts. This phase include the activity like a background music selection, sound and recording and so on and so forth. Text is incorporate using the OCR software, which we can produce using various software, and picture can shot by the digital camera, and then that means actual production will be start in during this phase. And then testing. Testing is very important. You can test in each and every phase or each and every steps, because if you are, for example, if you are planning some budget, then you have to test it whether that budget, when that budget will be released, and then all the testing will be happened. The similarly, if you are designing the structure, that again that there should be evaluation or testing will be there, that whether the structure is a planned structure or anything you need to include or exclude, like that. So testing is important. After completing the final product, the pilot product test will be done before the mass production to ensure that everything is in place, thereby avoiding the future of failure after launching. And also if it is a web-based production, its function is tested in different browsers like Internet Explorer, Chrome, or Mozilla and the Netscape etc. So this should be a free web browser based product. There should not be any problem with the web browser also. Also, if it is a local multimedia application for LAN, that must be deployed in a server for testing purpose. After testing process is over, then the product is incorporated with the valid suggested changes and all. Once the all the pilot test over with the various changes, suppose if it is required any changes, then after completing all the thing, then it will be ready for documentation. Then there should be a user documentation. It is mandatory for the user how it the multimedia package can be used. So, and apart from the user documentation, the other documentations are which will be saved appropriately and kept in the things. That means the content detail, email addresses and phone numbers, and also the content details include the basic the source file of audio, video and text format, even the graphic format also. So that any modification in future, any updation or any modification, this source file can be utilized for that modification. And finally, the delivering the multimedia product. The multimedia applications are best delivered on CD or DVD or in the websites. In reality, the various changes are faced while delivering the through internet, like bandwidth problem, huge number of plugins required to play the audio video, and long downloading time. So these are the things we have to take care when we are using for the web based delivery. And finally, the multimedia application is delivered in a more effective way by integrating the two mediums, like we can use both CD based and as well as the internet based. And we will come to the multimedia production team, which we have already discussed. And multimedia team members is a way to get maximum output with a high degree of efficiency is mandatory in the multimedia production. The fine quality, high-end multimedia production application require a specialized team comprising of the following members. First one is a production manager. In a multimedia production, the role of production manager is to define and coordinate and production of the multimedia project in time and with full quality. So that is very important. They have to coordinate with various people, various specialists, and also they have to produce the product in time and with the quality. And the production manager should be the expertise in the technology expert, good at the personal writing, good communication skill and budget management skill. That is very important in the multimedia production. And also a second one is a content specialist. This content specialist also having equal responsibility, because the content specialist is perform all research activity concerned with the proposed application content. The program content referred to the project information, graphics, data or fact presented through the multimedia production. And next one is a script writer. The script writer will help for video and film script presents a linear sequence of the event. The script writer visualizes the concept in a three-dimensional environment, and if needed, uses the virtual reality integration into the program. And text editor, the content of a multimedia production always must follow the logically, and the text should be always to be structured and correct grammatically, and the text and narration is an integrated part of the application. And multimedia architect, the multimedia architect integrate all the multimedia buildings blocks, like a graphic, text, audio, music, video, photos and animation by using the authoring software. After that, computer graphic artist. The role of computer graphic artist is to deal with the graphic elements of the programs like a backgrounds, buttons, bullets, picture editing, 3D objects, animation, logo, etc. And audio video specialist, the role of these specialists are needed for dealing with narration and digitized video to be added in the multimedia presentation. They are responsible for recording, editing sound effects and digitizing. Computer programmer. The computer programmer writes the lines of codes and scripts in the appropriate language. These scripts usually develops the special functions like developing the software to give the size and space for video windows, controlling the peripherals, etc. And finally, webmaster. The responsibility of webmaster is to create and maintain an internet web page. They convert a multimedia presentation into web page. The final multimedia product is ready for consultation in a joint effort of entire team. Initially, the project manager identifies the project content while the web manager webmaster provides the access to the wide range of community through the web services. Then we will discuss about the file format for the multimedia. So, first of all, we will discuss about the text format. The text formats are having the RTF, that is rich text format, is a primary file format introduced in 1987 by Microsoft. So, then there is a plain text. The plain text files can be opened, read and edited with the most text editors commonly used in the Notepad for Windows or Nano for Unix, Text Edit for Mac system and so on. So, other computer program also capable of reading the and importing the plain text. So, plain text is a original and the popular way of conveying the email also. So, most of the time we get the plain text from the content specialist, and then that plain text can be inserted in the various format. Next, we will discuss about the image formats. Image formats are TIFF format, that is tagged image file format. This format is common in desktop publishing and it supports by almost all the software packages. And bitmap image format, that is initially this format is used with the Windows 3.1. It is quite large and uncompressed, and hence the PMP is used for the high resolution or large images. Then device independent bitmap, that is DIB. This format, which is similar to BMP, allows the file to be displayed on the variety of devices. And GIF format, that is graphic interface interchange format. The GIF is a compressed image format. Most of the computer color images and the backgrounds are in a GIF formats. This file format is a best suitable for graphics that used only limited colors, and it is most popular format used on the online color photos. And JPEG format, that is JPEG, Joint Photographic Expert Group. JPEG was designed to attain maximum image compression. It uses the lossy compressing technique, where the compression method is referred those losses some of the data required for the image reconstruction. This work good with the photograph, artwork and similar material, but functions less on lettering, live drawing or simple cartoons. Tag TGA, it is the first popular format for high resolution images. Tag is supported by the most of the video capturing boards. PNG format, that is portable network graphics, is an extensible file format for less loose, portable and well compressed storage of raster images. Let us discuss the digital audio format, that is, we can use for the WAV, that is waveform audio file format, and MP3 format. MP3 format is a MPG layer 3 format, is a most popular format for storing and downloading the music. MP3 file format are roughly compressed 1/10 size of an equivalent of WAV files. OGG format is a free open source container format that is designed for obtaining better streaming and evaluating high end quality digital multimedia. And also further we can use the AFFF format for audio and WMA, that is a window media audio format, and RA, that is real audio format. These are the some of the audio format which can be used for the multimedia product. And digital video formats are there, that is AVI, which is most used by the digital video files. AVI is the video file format for Windows, and sound and picture elements are stored in an alternative chunk in the files. MPEG format, that is Movie Picture Expert Group, that is also is a standard for the generally digital videos and audio compression under the International Standard Organization. Then coming to the delivery of multimedia. So we can deliver the multimedia in two ways, that is the optical discs and the web-based one. The optical discs are the most cost-effective method of delivering the multimedia material. These devices are used to store large amount of combination of text, graph, sound and movie videos. There are many media, that is compact disc CD, it comes with the 650 MB storage, and DVD, that is for 4.7 GB, and then BD, that is also coming with the 27 GB storage capacity. And distributing through the networking, we can deliver the multimedia also. So suitable web-based content, for example, websites are there to deliver the multimedia product, and files need to be compressed before transfer through the networking. And the delivering the multimedia for web-based and CD-based, we can compare that web-based in limited in picture size and low video resolution, but in the CD-based we can store high-end multimedia elements. In web-based we can multimedia product can be changed, damaged or deleted by the irresponsible individual, because we are submitting in the open platform, that means websites, and this can be permanently storage and not changeable in the CD based delivery. Information can be updated easily and cheaperly, but information can be quickly outdated because we are storing permanently in this CD based delivery mechanism. So, in this video, we have discussed the multimedia production and delivering the process. So, we have discussed the how the multimedia file format, and also what type of delivery mechanism we can use to distribute the multimedia product. Thank you.